Hello, good evening to all my dear friends. Today my presentation topic is theme of the medieval arts. About George Eliot, Mary Ann Evans, known by her pen name George Eliot, was an English novelist, poet, journalist, translator and one of the leading writers of the Victorian era. She was written several novels. Adam Bede, 1859, The Mill on the Floss, 1860, Silas Marner, 1861, Romola, 1862-63, Flexi Holt, The Radical, 1866, Middlemarch, 1871-72, Daniel Derrida, 1876, most of which are set in provincial England and known for their realism and psychological insight. Although female authors were published under their own names during her lifetime, she wanted to escape the stereotype of women's writing being limited to light-hearted romances. She also wanted to have her fictions just separately from her already extensive and widely known work as an editor and critic. Introduction. Middlemarch is written by George Eliot, who was born on November 22, 1819. Eliot used to write her novels under a make pseudonyms Mary Ann Evans. This is highly unusual novels. Though it is primarily Victorian novels, it has many characteristics typical to modern novels. The subtitle of this novel, Study of Provincial Life, this means the Middlemarch retains the life of ordinary people, not the grand adventures of princes and kings. Middlemarch retains the spirit of 19th century England through the unknown historical remarkable common people. England is the process of rapid industrialization. We can find many things in this novel. Theme of the Middlemarch, responsibility. This is a major theme of Fred's story, and he must become responsible for his finances, and his choice will does to a certain extent. Both men must learn how to rely on themselves, not infringe upon other, and how to become independent in many ways. Stubbornness. Big issue of characters. Rosamond is extremely stubborn, meaning that if things are not done her way, she will go behind other people's back to do things the way she thinks they should be done. Societal stubbornness is responsible for Lydgate's failure with his medical practice. People want they were want for whatever reason, which means that they are blind to things that might be best for them. Prejudice, a theme that Lydgate and Lady Stello cannot seem to be. People in Middlemarch dislike anyone who is not from Middlemarch or anyone whose reputation seems questionable. Will and Lydgate are both good people, but it is initial prejudice sometimes based on invalid or circumstantial reasons that means that they are never liked or accepted in Middlemarch. Conformity, an issue that is related to societal expectations, but it somewhat different. People are supposed to conform to certain social ideas and norms. Dorothy is supposed to be a proper wife and then a proper widow, and follow society's set guidelines about how to fill each position. Will fits no positions that society tried to group him into, so he is disliked. He refuses to be conventions or proper or to fit into that society and its ideas of how someone like will should act. Love keeps people together, or the lack or it lets them drift apart. Those who are truly in love, like Will and Dorothea, Mary and Fred, are bound together by it and are very alike in temperament and outlook. Those who like it, like Lydia Gate and Rosamond, Casaubon's and Dorothea, are ill-suited to each other in marriage and are very disappointed by their unions. Unity of Middlemarch. The decision made by every person in the middle march seems to have a direct effect on at least one other person. Mary's decision to marry Fred means that Fairbrother's is without a wife. Dorothea's decision to choose Casaubon leads Sir James to choose Celia. Bulstrode's dirty dealing with regard to Raffles means disgrace to both Lydgates and Lady Sledo. Everyone in Middlemarch is intimately connected, and it seems that no one can move around without disturbing someone else. Social expectations closely linked to society's heresy are ideas about how everyone should act in certain situations. Lydgate proposes to Rosamond because society expects that he should do it. Dorothea is pushed to live with someone else or marry again after he is a widow because society expects that it is right. People don't necessarily follow these expectations, nor should they, but they do exist and play a part in people's life. Vanity, especially relevant to Rosamond's and her suitors, Rosamond is expansionally vain about her charms and her appearance so much that it is shock to her when her friend Lady Sledo says he doesn't love her. Her unsuccessful suitors all equally vain and blame Birket rather than Rosamond's lack of interest when she won't return their favor. Self-discovery. There are certain truths which every character learns about himself in the course of trials. Lydgates and Rosamond find out more about their character through their money trouble, though they do not always adjust accordingly. Dorothea makes the most dramatic journey of self-discovery and senses greeting within the course of the novel. Reality versus expectations. Many characters' preconceived ideas, especially of marriage, are proven tragically wrong in the course of the book. Casaubon and Dorothea both have unrealistic idea about marriage and are disappointed. Lydgate and Rosamond have the same idea and are let down. Life often defines what one expects or could predict of it, and the people who are happiest are the one who have few expectations or are the flexible. Progress. Much is changing in the world of Middlemarch. English society is evolving in social, economic, technology areas. Socially, ideas of gender and class are in flux as women are proving more and more competent, and the industrial revolution is causing a greater amount of social mobility. The economy of England is changing from the aristocratic inheritance-based system on holding wealth and land to one based on commerce, business and manufacturing. Technology is also changing in medical science and in areas like transportation, and these are signs that they are beginning to sweep through Middlemarch. Conclusion. In this novel, we can say many things. In this novel, everything is political in Middlemarch, with most of people strongly backing the Conservative Party. People within the novel have varying ideas of family obligation. In this novel, though it is strong force in Middlemarch society, people of high status are generally treated more delicately than people with little money like Lydgate and Lady Sledo. Birth and connection are also important in determinations of person, place and also what benefit they can receive from society. Thank you.